Welcome to my YouTube channel, Admiral Ghost. In this video, I'll be showing you how to root this box Academy, and basically this is a medium difficulty machine from Hackthebox. So let's quickly go and see the Nmap report first. So here we have port 22 open, which is open SSH, and this box is running on Ubuntu machine. Then we have port 80, which is running Apache. And we have port 33060, which is MySQL export. So let's go and see what is there on port 80. So we have this login and register functionalities available here. Okay, so we have a register functionality available here. Let's quickly have a monitor as well here so that we can see what all traffic is going on. Let's quickly register a user, let's say test user. Let's use same password, and here's the register request. It says welcome and then it drops out. So maybe our user was registered but we were not able to see the request. Let's do preserve log and try to register once more. Say let's test user 2, test user password, test user is password, and let's do register and see what our register request look like. So let me make it bigger. So that was a GET request. Here's the post request. So we sent in the test user 2 password and we sent it the role ID. So this is something which is of interest. While let's copy this request first as a curl command, or you may use burp as well, whatever you feel comfortable with. Okay, let's have it copy here. Let's try to log in first with test user. So here's the username test user. Sorry, here's the username test user 2. The password is test user. So if you see here, we have a basically a static page which does nothing. We have very limited vectors, attack vectors here. So while enumerating this further, I also found the admin.php panel. So when I do the search on this, I find this admin panel, and if I try to log in here, then I'm not allowed to log in. So if we see the network here, let's try to log in another time, and here is the post request, and I'm sending user ID and password, and in response I'm getting nothing. No session cookie is set here. So if you remember this, while registering the user we have this attribute role ID as well. So what if we try to change it from 0 to 1? Let's create another user, let's say 3. Okay, now if we try to log in now, test user 3, password is test. Password is test user. Okay, so it does allows us to log in. So this time what we did, instead of creating a regular user, we just tweaked in with the role ID this attribute, and we were allowed to log in as admin. So basically this is used as a flag kind of thing to inform whether the user is a regular user or an admin user. Now if you see here, we have few checklist type of thing. We have this complete initial set of modules for these users. So maybe these are the users we have to target. Then we have this virtual host dev staging 01. So let's quickly do add these to a host file. So if you open the host file, I already have done the changes. So if you see here, I have the IP and I have the virtual host mapped with this. So you have to do this in your host file if you have not done it. Then let's visit. So this is some kind of exception, and here is the laravel.log file. That means Laravel CMS is used. And if you see here, we have the admin@stb. We have the app key here for the Laravel framework. Then we have database user homestead. Password is not there. So let's try and see if we can find any CVs related to Laravel. Okay, so I found a number of CVs here, and while checking them out, I found this CV to be present in this particular application. So what this CV is this allowed remote code execution and is occur as a result of a unserialized call to a potentially interested SSRF value. So let's go and see if we can have any exploit available for this. And I'm searching CV base for the publicly available exploits, and if you see, we have 9 exploits available here. Okay, so these are some exploits, and I found this one to be interesting and easy to use. So not this one actually. So actually I used this exploit because this was quite easy to use. All you need to do is install the requirements and then issue the commands. So it seems quite easy to use. That's why I used this one, the second one here. Let's quickly git clone it. Move it to the folder. Just if you have not done it, then you can do pip install requirements.txt. I already do have install requirements installed, so I'm skipping this part. Let's do python 3 pon laravel.py -h is for help, -c is for command. Let's say we want to issue command ls, and we have to specify the URL and API key. So the URL is this one, okay, and the app key is here. We have this base64 encoded key. Let's see if it works. Okay, so it appears to be working. We got the output of this command ls. Now what we can do is we can have a shell here, So I have this IP 10.10.14.10.10.14.169. Let me run a listener first. Let's say I have a listener on port 4757. Now instead of this command, I can ask the script to run this command. So basically this is the command for getting a bash reverse shell. Okay, so if things work properly, I will get a reverse shell on port 4757. Cool, so I have the reverse shell now. And if I do ls, I have this web.config. Let's move one folder back and see what all our files here. Here we have .environment file, which is quite interesting, and it does contain environment variables. So we have Redis, we have database, and no secret is there. This is the default value secret. We have only app key and nothing else here. Maybe we can move one folder back. And if we see here, we have two virtual hosts. So this is the one through which we got this shell, and this is the one which hosts the static page which we saw earlier. Let's move into this and see the contents. Instead, let me do ls-al. We have server. We have .environment file here as well. Let's see if it does contain something interesting. And if you see here, we have this database academy username dev, and we have a password here. Let's see if this password is used by any other user. So if I do ls home, I have these users, and let's do it recursively to see which user has the user.txt file here. So we have this user.txt file here inside this users folder, and maybe this is the user we want to compromise. So let's try if this password works for this user. Okay, the user does not exist. Maybe I type in something wrong. We have the password here. Let me copy the username. Okay, now for the password, let me paste here the password. And okay, so we haven't got the confirmation, but the password was successful. And if I do bash-i, I am in an interactive shell and I have got this user. So if I go to the home of this user, we have the user.txt, and here we got the user.txt. Now to escalate privileges, let's see first ID. So I am inside admin, and this admin group is basically used to see logs. So let's just have a Python listener to get linpeace, and if see wget is there. Okay, so let's download linpeace.sh from my host, and then I'll be running it for further enumeration. So this is taking some time. Till the time we can do SSH to the host. Password was my super password. Okay, so till the time this is also done, let's do chmod 755 linpeace.sh and then run the linpeace.sh and store the output to, let's say, linout, and we run it in background. Okay, so if I do jobs, I have this job running in background, and I already have done it previously to save the time, and I have this output available here, linout. So let's open it with this, and while scrolling through this output, I found one interesting stuff. So here I found this thing interesting. So there's a hex input here, and this is basically pass to SEO, so maybe this is a password for the some kind of a user. So what we can do is we can go and check hex decoder. And let's try to decode it. Okay, so we have this Marvin Academy, and if you see here, we got two users listed here. So first one was this, from which we got the user.txt, and the next user is this Marvin. So let's try and do switch user to Marvin. Okay. And it does work. If I do who am I, I am Marvin now. If I do ID, I am still a regular user. So what we can do is see if we have access to sudo. And this is not command. So if I do sudo hyphen l, it says that I am allowed to run. Everyone is allowed to run this user bin composer. So I can run this user bin composer with sudo user privileges. So if I do composer hyphen h, it does not provide much of information. But if I go and do man composer, so here we can check for some methods using which we can go and run custom commands. And if you see here this run script, so this allows to run the scripts in composer.json file. So if we have a script composer.json, then it will allow us to run the commands. So what we can quickly do is we can go and create this scripts here. So we are just echoing scripts and we are making a composer.json file. So first let's see if we have access to write files here. And permission denied. Let's move to dev SHM. Let's try now. Okay, so I have dev now. So let's create the composer.json here. Okay, so we have this composer.json. Next, we need to run this command as sudo user, and I have defined a script here with the name x, and I am running this command root.txt. So I have to specify the Marban's password, and here I also got the password, but this is due to somebody else might be using the box, and that's why it is there in plain text. So it gives us a warning that do not run Composer as root user, and it is no such file or directory. So unable to find dynamic library mysqli.so. So maybe we want to, okay, so composer.json has been removed from here. Let's try to again copy and paste. Let's verify this is here. Now let's rerun this command. And here we have the roots flag. So that's it for this video. I hope you like it. If you have any suggestions or queries, or you want to raise any improvement suggestion, then please drop your comments in the comment section. Thanks for watching, and see you soon.